Good evening to all of you. Please settle down. There are some places available here for those who don't mind the Indian asan, can come and sit here. My apologies to everybody for the inconvenience caused because we cannot provide adequate seating arrangement for everybody here. Places here, somebody wants to comment it. I can see a couple of chairs here. Right. I think we'll have to close the door so that more people don't come in. In these times, only Narendra Modi can get a larger audience than Nilesh Bhai. And I think the audience of Narendra Bhai will not go richer than you will go because of the content Nilesh Bhai is going to present to us. Let me begin. Chairman of our HR committee, Mr. Mayur Nayak, our convener there, Nilesh Bhai, all the young friends over here. The audience, which has come in such large numbers, has come with a definite aim in mind. Everybody wants to pass the CA exam. Right? Is there anybody who doesn't want to pass? Right? Right. So, Mayur Bhai reminded me that the pass percentage is about 30%, which is what the latest trends are. He assures that after listening to the lecture, the average of this will be more than 3%. That is what is guaranteed. There are two ways of clearing your CA exam. One is the right way, what Nilesh Bhai did, and one is something which I don't recommend, which is the way I passed my CA. So let me quickly tell you what all I did, and I don't recommend it for anybody. I started my CA after my graduation. None of you want to do it, right? All of you want to do it with, I wanted to enjoy my college life peacefully, get my good grades in BCom, which I didn't get, that's another thing, but I did enjoy. I analyzed why people are not able to study for their CA exam, and I realized some young boys, you know, they were studying in the library, but eyes were elsewhere, girlfriends and whatnot. So I said, I will not do that. Come on, I didn't mean that I'll not have a girlfriend. I got married to my girlfriend. Even before I did my CA inter. The next thing I did was, I said, I'm not here for the ranks and all that. So I'll give one group at a time. And that worked for me. I did not get marks worthy of rank, but I did not fail also. So I cleared. And lastly, what I did was, I did not stress myself. Because of my grades in BCom and school, nobody had any expectations from me. So I built a low expectation. So the mere fact that I passed, people were very happy, you know. So that's something. But again, I say I don't recommend except for a few who probably liked the marriage bit. Okay. Nilesh Bhai actually doesn't require any introduction. Frankly, tell me, should I waste 5-7 minutes of your time talking about him, or would you like to listen to him? Exactly. So we're not going to introduce Nilesh Bhai, but we got to welcome him with a loud applause. This program is free for all, right? Did anybody pay for this program? No, but anything that is free comes with some sponsorship time, some advertisement. So can I do a minute of advertisement of BCA? Okay. I'm sure if all of you shouted no with a loud sound, I'd still have done that. So it doesn't matter. It was just a rhetorical question. Okay, now just a quick one. Bombay Chartered Accountants Society, I'm not getting into the history. It's there on the website. You can all get into that. These are the kind of programs Bombay Chartered Accountants Society is doing for students. There are numerous programs during the year. Not all of them study related. We also believe that institute gives you enough, does not give you enough time for enjoyment. At BCA, we also do programs where you can de-stress and can excel in other areas. The HR committee, under the guidance of Mr. Mayur Naik, organizes a program which is an elocution and debate program, which is very well attended, and there are lovely opportunities there. This year, God willing, everything going right, we are starting a youth festival, which is still in the planning stage, but somewhere in the month of June, we will have a festival, which is no studies, no nothing, complete dhamal. When are your exams getting over? 9th of June. So it has to be after 9th June so that all of them can attend. The reason is because for a CA, you know, we do not go to any college. Engineers, MBAs, doctors, architects, lawyers, everybody go to college. They have their own alumni. What alumni do you and I have? So those who go to Big Four and all that, probably yes, they have, you know, alumni there. But somebody like me who went to a very small firm, you know, me and the partner, two people and probably the pun, three of us, what alumni are we going to have? Okay, so this is an opportunity for all of us to make BCAS our alumni. You come here, you study, you have your study circles, you have your programs, and also the entertainment. And the best part is the networking. You know, once you are a member of BCA, which batch, which year, seniors, juniors, all of us can get together, studies as well as the business development. Jobs, I know BCA is one forum where a lot of senior chartered accountant comes to do headhunting and stuff like that. So I urge you, whether you become member or don't become member, that's a choice you have. It's a 50 rupees, I think, with the stipend, which is today 50 rupees a year you can afford. But even if that you don't want, at least leave your emails and phone numbers here so that we can keep you posted on certain things that we are doing. I think I've spoken more than a minute. With that, I request Mr. Mayur Naik to give our token of appreciation on behalf of all of us. And now, for the moment we've all been waiting, Nilesh Vikramsingh.
May I request, I think people who are standing even here, you can sit in the middle because at least this will be about an hour or so, maybe more depending on your patience, not my patience. I can speak for 2 hours also. So I think standing you might be troubled. There's some space in the middle. I think those who are standing here, can you come in the middle over there? Or here itself you can sit down if you want. I leave the choice to you. If you want to stand, you can stand. That's your prerogative. How much stamina you have after a full day's work. President of Bombay Chartered Accountants Society, Naushad. Chairman of the HR Committee of Bombay Chartered Society, Mayurbhai Naik. Coordinator of the program, Raj Khona, who is himself a very prolific speaker. He has been attending speaking at various national conventions of our institute. I have seen him, of all places, in a place like Siliguri, coming all the way from Bombay to Siliguri, which is in Bengal, you know, which is the cusp of the northeastern states. And all my dear, you know, friends over here, handsome boys, charming girls. First, let me, you know, give an honest confession. I am not a professor. I don't take any classes. So I am not too sure whether after 1.5 or 2 hours, you'll go back with a lot of ideas in your mind. I think the reason, Naushad, it's not my name which is old, it's the title, Success in CA Examination. I think that is what has brought all of you, right? See, that's the...
They want to say yes to everything.
So I realize that. And of course, your response has put a lot of onus on my shoulders. What I propose to do is take you through about an hour or so basic tips over the last 28 years. See, I've got, I've come from a firm called Kimji Kuwarji and Company, which is a typical mid-sized firm. In 28 years, I would have gone through almost, I think, a couple of hundred students under me, in the sense, under the firm. A lot of experiences sharing out of that. And last 4 years, I have been part of the institute at the Central Council. I was member of the examination committee in 2010-11. I was chairman of Board of Studies in 2012-13. So possibly keeping that background in mind, Mayurbhai met me in a wedding about a month back. And we started discussing the results. The results have been only 3%, this, that. The students are feeling there is some, you know, reduction of marks, etc., just to manage the results. I said, there's nothing of that type. So a lot of things which I'm going to speak initially is going to be general in the presentation, which of course, absolutely valuable from your perspective. You can take it as a sort of a reference check. Whatever suits you, accept it. If it doesn't suit you, don't accept it. I'll leave the choice to you. It's a collation of the experiences which we have had. After that, we'll close at some time. We'll have a fixed time. So maybe 7:30 or so, we'll close it. Then let's have some question answers. In the sense, assuming I have not cleared some doubts, you know, there are certain things which is not part of the presentation. In the sense, whether we reduce the result to some question may come. You can ask it openly, which may not be part of it. Whatever doubts, misconception, myths in your mind, and I'll try to answer to the best of my ability. Some things I'll be able to answer, something I may not be able to answer from the confidentiality perspective. So keeping that bounds in mind, let's, you know, before I start, how many of you, just for my own knowledge, are at the CA final level? Just by a raise of hands, predominantly. How many are sort of at the CPT level? Nobody? IPCC? Few. My focus will be more from the final CA level. The reason who are people who are doing at the IPCC level, my focus will be more from the final CA perspective. First and foremost, how many of you have, you know, sort of failed any exam, whether it is CPT, IPCC, or maybe any other exam? How many of, I have failed. Like, before I ask the question, I have failed, let me tell you. Possibly there was another reason why Mayurbhai may have, you know, asked me as a speaker, not a brilliant rank holder, but somebody who has failed in life. So both of us are in the same. So I think we have got a lot of like-minded people, so don't worry. I think a lot of inputs may be of help. I think my purpose will be served at least if you carry back something home. This presentation will be circulated later on, maybe on email, etc. It will be emailed to you. You can keep it as a reference check. Right now, if you want, you can note down in your notebooks, and later on, once it gets on email, you can sort of have a look at it. First and foremost, as you see the, this is again the logo of our institute, the eagle. See, what does it say? When it rains, most birds occupy shelter, but eagle is the only bird that fly above the clouds. So I want you to do the same thing. In the sense, whether it is CA exams, whether it is any other exam, you have to be above the clouds. You should not be in those, you know, whether any problematic questions, any, you know, trick googly ones, you should be able to handle that. What is the receipt for success? Study while others are sleeping, work while others are loafing, prepare while others are playing, and dream while others are wishing. This is by William Ward, and this holds absolutely true for us in the sense as CA students. And I'm going to share a lot of things where you'll get this theme running across the presentation. How is the presentation structured? I think a lot of this you may be knowing: planning, time management, timetable, student journal, materials issued by the Board of Studies, learning in practical training, that is your articleship, coaching classes, tuitions. Despite all those things, why do people fail? I think how many of you are not doing coaching classes here? Oh, reasonably good number. Reasonably good number. In the sense, though I would say at least 80-90% are doing. So despite why the failures, then the study methods, writing practice, revision, approach to practical subjects, concentration, I'll speak about that. Another, you know, before I get into concentration, how many of you keep your mobile near you whilst you're studying? Honestly, see here, it is for your own, this thing, it is gradually some. So first thing is you need to keep it away, and we'll speak more about that. Knowledge management, attitude, break time, or whatever you do, your break time, answering techniques, other action points, successful failures. This will inspire
people like me who have failed. People have succeeded after our failures. General examination tips, exam day tips, subject-wise suggestion. I may not go into the subject-wise suggestion because I think we may not have enough time. Useful links, some motivational clips. So first and foremost is planning. I think we heard, it's a buzzword, you know. Failing to plan is planning to fail. I think all of us agree. So do you plan your schedule of your studies? From when does it start? Only during the leave period or earlier than that? Earlier than that. Chalo, good. So at least a lot of it, as I told you, a lot of these points will be common. But even if one person is not doing it, any of the things which I'm going to say, a lot of this, see, they say common sense is not common. So what I'm going to speak is going to be a lot of this thing. Maybe you'll say, okay, this I know. But are you implementing it? Knowing is one thing. Theoretically, I may know, I need to do this. So are you implementing this? So it's absolutely essential. Planning, and not only during the leave period or whatever, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, whatever leave you're taking, depending on one group, two groups. There is no alternate to hard work. You have to work hard. In the sense, again, depending on your ability, 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours, 15 hours of study during leave period. Other than study also, whilst you're working, whilst you're studying in college, whilst you're doing your coaching classes, irrespective of that, you have to do some studies. And I'll tell you where your time wasters are and how you can get that time. Set your own target based on your capacity and expectation. Each person has got its own capacity. For example, when I was studying, like Naushad said, even I was not a rank holder. I used to study in a college and I used to observe that some persons used to study for almost 14 to 16 hours. And I couldn't do more than 8 hours of effective study. Mind you, the difference is effective study. Understanding what is being read. When my mind used to give away in the sense of capacity, I used to take a nap also, a power nap. And we'll discuss that also. So each person will be different. Somebody will have capacity seminar to read for 14 hours, 16 hours, somebody may not have. So don't, but be aware what is happening. Time management. Again, like the planning, the timetable, which subject, when, even before the leave starts, you need to start planning out. This is my going to be roadmap for my studies. This is the theory papers, this is the practical papers, this is how I'm going to study. The many times I wonder, you know, despite 80-90% of the students going to coaching classes, why is there so much failure? I think that we need to introspect. And I'll give you my reason for that, as we, that is also part of the presentation. Devote time for daily studies and find time for regular studies out of a busy schedule. No? You're doing, you'll say, I've got morning college and articleship and then my classes, Saturdays, Sundays. Despite that, you'll have to take out time. Maybe at least 2 hours every day. At least 2 years before the exam start. Not the first of your articleship when you're struggling with the articleship. Maybe 1.5 years before the exam start. 2 hours every day you need to take out. Now, how you take out is your problem. Whilst you're traveling, you'll say, I'm staying at Mira Road. Somebody will say, I'm staying at Thana. I'm coming to Dadar or wherever. Get into the train, find a seat, maybe go back to, you know, the last station and then come back, go to Virar and come back or do whatever. While standing, you may not be able to sitting, but find a way out. See, problem, I'll tell you, life, everybody's got a problem. You have your own problems, we have our own problems, you have to find a solution. So ultimate aim is, how do I find a solution? My aim is I want to study 2 or 3 hours every day, despite this whole, you know, routine of my college, classes and articleship. That you need to make out. Another thing is, many times we focus, some of us, some of the subjects are favorite for us. For example, for me, the practical subjects are very favorite, in the sense accounting, costing, FM, so on and so forth. And the theory subjects were, you know, sort of. But unfortunately, whether it is our favorite or not, if you want to pass the exams, you have to get minimum 50 in that paper. Of course, 40, but I'm saying average, you have to get 50. So no choice, whether it you like the subject or not, you have to get a receipt for cracking that particular paper. You know, somebody says, I don't like this OR or, you know, something else, audit or tax or whatever, depending on which. Each person will have his own, you know, favorite or non-favorite, I would say. So, but that the exam committee doesn't bother for it, the issue doesn't bother for your liking or disliking. Even if you dislike a subject, you have to focus and crack it. So don't only look at your favorite subject. Many times it happens, you like some subject, you'll focus more on that. If I like accounts, I'll keep on doing more of accounts. I'll do less of maybe company law, maybe less of direct tax or indirect tax, but that is not possible. Another problem is in the theory subject. Generally, I think a lot of you, how many of you would agree that one doesn't remember? We read once maybe a topic, and you after 1 month, you read the same topic, you don't remember. I think majority of us. So one of the techniques which has been discussed and which has been implemented found to be good is you finish that particular topic. Before you start the next topic, just revise it quickly. Normally, we keep a revision. You know, what we do is we read the whole subject and we keep the revision after maybe a few months. Rather than doing it, a small change, small iteration, a quick revision of that particular topic before you start the next topic of that subject, whichever that thing is. So just see, it'll make a difference. As I mentioned, you need to harness your time. Just imagine how much time you're using in your travel. And you're just assuming in an average, if you're using 1 hour in travel, is that the average everywhere? But I'm saying minimum one side, 1 hour, to every day 2 hours. If you take 500 days of your articleship, I'm saying effective 500 days, maybe sometime could be more or less. If you ready, if you study for 2 hours of the travel time, how many hours it will be? And how many number of days? Convert into 8 hours, 10 hours, whatever. If it converted to 10 hours, it'll be 100 days. So 100 days of study time you have if you study for those 2 hours. What do you do? Generally, what I do, I can afford it now, is when I get into a train or something, WhatsApp, this, that, right? How do you spend time on this? So can we change that time and start studying? Finally, the question is, this particular thing is supposed to be a tool for us to help. This or whatever. But what has happened is we have become slaves. Now, honestly, I'm also a slave of this, but I can afford. I've cleared my exams. You are not clear, so you can't be a slave to this. Whether it's your WhatsApp, whether it's your Facebook, whether it is whatever. You need, actually, this is one of the most destructive things as far as your success to this examination is concerned. Absolutely destructive. How many of you are not on Facebook or on WhatsApp? I'm good. I'm happy. You'll succeed. Balance, I don't guarantee, unless they stop this and harness. And I'm going to, many people keep their mobiles during studying. Forget the travel time and all. When you're studying, if this is going to beep or this is going to show you a message, what are you going to happen? Tuck, tuck, tuck. The way I do it. As I do, I can afford, you can't afford. But what happens when you do that? When you're studying, you need absolute concentration. See, CA study is not your study for BCom or BSc or BA. It requires absolute concentration and focused concentration. And this, even a slight distraction on this, gone. So this has to be kept under lock and key. When you're studying, take it out during lunchtime, any important messages or etc. Tell your friends, I'm going to look at it in your family, that this particular WhatsApp or whatever messages, anything else I'm going to do only during lunchtime or break time, tea time or lunchtime. So I'm not saying don't do that. Till the time you clear your CA exams, use it in an absolute disciplined manner. And this is the core. In my view, if I assess, this is the core, that concentration is lacking. All of you are much, much smarter than what we were, Naushad, myself, Mahir, during our times. Your information, your awareness levels are 100 times better than us. We are dumb, let me tell you, at your age. You're much smarter, but if the results are not commensurate, it's only because of the lack of concentration. So you need to concentrate. So travel time, instead of your WhatsApp and all those things, switch that. Regular studies, you need regular studies. And this study also has to be as per schedule. It cannot be wavered. Today I do something, tomorrow I do something else. It has to be, even the studies before your leave period has to be as per a table. I'll do it during this week so and so, during this month so and so, maybe whatever suits you. And so you can't do practical things in the train and all, but at least reading theory and all you can do in train or something else. Incidentally, for your benefit, I think it should also has come out with e-learning where is there an audio available. In sense, there's a PowerPoint and audio. You can download the PowerPoint on your mobile and just put it the earplugs rather than listening to music. You can listen to the lectures of the people through a PowerPoint presentation You can listen to that. So it's available with you and it's free, completely free. Downloadable and completely free. So you need to study regularly and consistently. Next is, as I told you when we discussed earlier, it has to be effective. See, don't get bogged down by what the other person is doing. Somebody is reading 12 hours, 15 hours, despite that he may fail. But what you are doing, is it effective? Is it going into your head? Absolutely essential. Ek reading ho gaya, but samajh rahe ho ki nahi aap? Are you understanding? There's a difference between reading and understanding. So till the time you understand, it is not effective reading. Many times it happens, you start reading in the morning. And it used to happen with me and I tell you what I used to do. By evening you're fatigued. By evening or maybe afternoon you're fatigued. What do you do? Okay, take a 20 minute break, 30 minute break, power nap. As I told you, I was studying in a college, in a classroom. Just put my head down, 20, 30 minute power nap. Let the mind become fresh again. Or maybe go for a walk. Do something else for the 20th, but again, effective. Not like so gaya to seedha. How many of you are studying at home and how many of you are studying in the library? How many of you are studying at home? Oh, this is another recipe for disaster. And I'll come to that. Unless your homes are so big and you've got so many servants, etc., you'll be completely not disturbed, then it's okay. But otherwise, this is a sure recipe for disaster, let me tell you. Any guests coming up, problem. Any errands running up, you cannot say no to your family members. TV going on at some time disturbing you. Is that all the thing happens? And sometimes you feel tired of you. How many of you read on the bed? Kya hota hai? You're sitting on a bed, you're reading. Thak gaye. What happens? So these are your simple things. I think why I'm saying these, we're sharing out our experiences. These are simple things. You need to introspect where you're going. Suppose these people have failed. I baithe and neend aake so gaye. Then you don't keep track of time. 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour. Break time is essential, but how much of the break is again, you know. So if you're in a college, if you're in a classroom, you'll put your head down, you'll sleep. You cannot sleep for 1 hour, 2 hours. Itne thake hue ho, ke 20-25 minute mein toh theek hai, tabhi utne, you'll be having a sleep of 20-30 minutes. Automatically you'll get up. Because it's not a comfortable sleep. You're just putting your head down. Aur ghar pe baithe hai, toh bistar pe kya hota hai? Completely 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, you don't know at all what is happening. So, have effective study. What we're trying to convey is, jabardasti ki padhai mat karo. Whether you're understanding, that is absolutely essential. Endeavor that at least the entire syllabus is completed at least once before the commencement of the study leave. Possible? Plan. Jo na dish kar raha hai. And despite your classes, if you say no, I'm saying once is including your classes and all. And I'll come to the classes also, right? Despite classes you're failing. Endeavor to complete the first revision within 1.5 month of leave period. Again, maine aise nahi kiya tha, but this is what a current team, people have passed successfully. 1.5 for 2 months ho sakta hai, or 2.5 months ho sakta hai. But the idea is keep some time for revision and keep some time for the problem areas. Jahan pe samajh nahi aa raha uske liye zyada time dene ke liye later on. We'll talk of the break time activity. We discuss a little bit. Another important thing. How many of you are doing articleship in a? Or let me ask another question, not that way. CA final, how many of you studied for 6 months? Just frankly, nobody's going to catch you. We're discussing openly. 6 months. And have you appeared or you didn't succeed? You'll be appearing for the first time. Anybody who appeared after studying for 6 months, you appeared? Anyway. The point is, each person, see, we have to peak at the right time. There is something called law of diminishing marginal utility in economics. Have you heard? And that is equally applicable to CA studies. I've seen in my own earlier part of the career, like in my office, people used to take a transfer in the third year. Why? 8 mahina padhna hai, 12 mahina padhna hai. Ek wo fad, coaching class ne fad chala diya ki if you don't study, you will not... But they don't understand, despite that 8 months, 6 months, people fail. And why do they fail? Because they are not peaking at the right time. You need to peak at the right time. When you're cracking on your exam, that has to be a peak. If you're going to study more, if you peaked earlier, then the negative return starts. ये तो मैंने पढ़ लिया है, मैं तो आ गया, I've read it once, twice, thrice, four times, whatever. So what is your peak? You yourself have to, you know, sort of pace accordingly. For example, somebody is, you know, preparing for a marathon. He'll be practicing hard, but he has to peak during the marathon. So despite that, there's a problem. When he runs a marathon, there'll be cramps. Here or some. See, they don't run for 21 kilometers or 42 kilometers during the practice session. They may run for 10 kilometers or whatever, once in a week, twice in a week. Uske bavajood, they are able to successfully complete the marathon despite cramps because they're peaking at that point of time. They don't, you know, run for 42 kilometers regularly. Otherwise, they'll not be able to run by that time. So they'll lose all the energy and stamina by the time they hit the marathon. So peak at the right time, that is very important. Another, you know, this is Mr. Manoharan's suggestion. T.N. Manoharan is the past president of my institute. He also spoken on BCA at the same very, you know, session, how to succeed in examination. And let me admit, I have borrowed from him one or two things. What he says, again, each person is style. This I'm reiterating what Mr. Manoharan has said. First reading, read it casually. In the sense, okay, you run through it. Fast, something may go into your mind, something may not go to your mind. At least you'll be aware what is there. Awareness will be there. Second reading, jot points. That will be more intense. Prepare your own notes. And exercise and solve problems more than one time. Third reading has to be for tying up the loose ends. You know, whatever you don't understand, all those things have to be tied up with third time. That is his suggestion, how you want to... One way. Again, what I'm going to say is all different approaches, practices. Whether it suits you, it's up to you whether to absorb this particular practice. He is a professor, he's teaching in classes. So I would respect that he's got much more knowledge as far as these type of things are concerned. So I would go by it. So this is the three readings which you, again, people have been saying, you know, one round before the exams, another is during your exam leave, 1.5-2 months, and third is the last. How many of you, do you get the CA student journal? How many of you run through it? Good. So all the latest notifications are there. How many of you look at the, you know, any of the financial newspapers? Economic Times. Balance, have to start looking at it. At least glancing through it, be current. Many times it happens, the CA students, people say in the campus interviews that they are maybe good technically, but they're completely dumb. They don't know what is happening currently. So we don't want to be dumb, we need to be smart. So run through the financial papers also. And CA journal and the student's journal, just run through it. If any amendments are there, you'll come to know what are the, you know, especially last 6-8 months before the exam, a lot of things, notifications come. You know, for example, when I was the Board of Studies chairman, we took a very, very bold decision that as far as IPCC is concerned, certain portion of this IT paper, information technology, will not ask. It's a completely redundant, things which, you know, is no longer there in information technology. So we said we are not going to ask questions. So it will straight away save your time. Assuming there's 100 pages, 100 pages of less study. So keep on tracking that. For example, now the Companies Act is there. There's a recent notification that will be applicable in May 2014 or maybe November. So you need to be, you know, tracking those changes. Materials issued by Board of Studies. How many of you refer to the study material? Good. In my own office, when we did this particular thing about a year or two back, only one girl raised her hand that she only goes through the study material. Balance, nobody's, I think, I don't know whether this is an honest answer. We discussed openly. I said, why don't you look at the study material, sir? 500 pages there. Or maybe 800 pages, 1,000. So why don't you look at that 500 pages? No, sir, coaching class is 150 pages. Right? That is a typical mindset. But believe me, coaching classes is there only, wants only you. Their whole purpose is that you pass the exams. That is it. And they'll cut corners, they're commercial this thing. Need to know basically itne hi cheez aa raha hai, ye cheez chota subject hai, ye karo, ye mat karo, itne some subjects, some topics they'll not cover. I'm not against coaching classes. Whatever they do, utna bhi aap achhe karoge, there will be a good basic preparation for you. But it is not complete. What they teach is not complete. And it is, lot of thing is mechanical. They don't teach you fundamentally. Whereas the study material which you have, why is bulky? Because it's trying to give you fundamental knowledge. That's why it is bulkier. So it can be a reference tool also, and no knowledge, you know, you will not be able to proceed in your life or maybe gain in your life unless you have got fundamental knowledge. कोचिंग क्लास वाला आपको वो एग्जाम तक तो पहुंचा देगा, नसीब अच्छे होंगे तो पास हो जाएगा, और वो नसीब जनरली अच्छे नहीं होते. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ द एग्जाम कमेटी आल्सो नोज व्हाट इज योर माइंडसेट एंड दे विल. सो ऑलवेज रिफर टू द स्टडी मटेरियल दो इट इज बल्की. सेकंड, वी हैव गॉट प्रैक्टिस मैनुअल्स. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू लुक एट द प्रैक्टिस मैनुअल्स? आरटीपी इज गुड. आई थिंक दैट नन ऑफ यू विल फेल इफ यू गोइंग थ्रू ऑल दिस थिंग. सो लुक एट दैट. If time permitting, if you want, you can have one other reference, book as a study material, or additional reference book. One. My suggestion, you may have 2-3 if you have got time. But the more you do, I don't want you to be confused more. Maybe each textbook may have a different, sort of a, approach. So best is study material, at the most, if you have got time permitting, one more. If you don't also refer, I don't think heavens are going to fall. That's what my belief is. And I have not refer to any textbook during my time, and I hope the same remains now. Maybe one odd thing could be okay. We only used to look at Shukla Agrawal that time for accounts, which was a thick, voluminous thing. So, but that I would leave it to you. If you want, we refer to one more book. After you decide the book, you do your due diligence before you decide the book. Talk to people, find out. Once you decide, don't have second thoughts. What will happen is once you are halfway through, some of your friends will say, "Nahi, ye nahi." For example, "Oh, Paduka acha hai." Somewhere something else is good. Well, nakki kar lo, then it's like marriage. Stick to one person. Sahi galat jo bhi hai, life mein adjustment karna padta hai. So stick to one book, because you don't have time for sticking to more, and you don't have time to get confused. So study material at the most one particular, and that also time permitting. Otherwise, not required. And there's some background over here. What is the basis for choosing the reference book, language, summarization, or so and so forth. As I mentioned, this e-learning module of the institute is downloadable from the institute itself. Suppose you are at the office and you've got idle time, and assuming you've got access to the net and all, you can download and start, rather than killing your time elsewhere, start listening to this. Don't kill your time. Even the study model, many times recently also some students from my office came to me, "Sir, when is the study model going to come?" So finally, I think a group ka aagya. Number one, I can't understand why people can't buy. This is a third year article or a second year article. Since IPCC clear karne ka final, why don't you take the material upfront? It is possible that the tax material will change. So that you can buy, or you can download also. Forget buying, you can download. Each and every study model is downloadable. So till the time you have got a physical copy, my suggestion would be buy the physical copies, and in case it changes, especially only the tax and indirect tax changes. Baki change is rare, IT, like for information technology, is once in a blue moon we change. It's not as if it is on a regular basis, we keep on changing that. Of course, when I was the board of studies, we gave this mandate that even the information technology, we need to keep it just like changing, just like the direct tax, because the information technology changes are so rapid. So best is buy the material and download whatever is changed. Coming to this practical, training. How many of you are, I can just, you can raise my hand. How many of you are with sole proprietor firms, one partner firm? How many of you are with, maybe I'll change my question. How many of you with four partner plus firms? Quite a few. Okay. Articleship, in my view, is the most invaluable learning across the world. Forget India. Nowhere in the world you have got this type of a concept where you can go live to the business. See what is that? What is the learning which you do during your articleship? Assuming you are doing, say, audit. One option is, see, what happens in US also. First you have to finish your CPA and then you have to do your training. It is only in India where as a student you can, do this practical training. And why I am saying it is invaluable? Today, where else in the world, nowhere in the world, you are a student, you are going for, say, an audit. What are you learning there in the audit? You will come back, a lot of people used to come back, "Sir, aap kya aap sirf tikda marne ka kaam hai, abhi bhi jana hai," right? Tikda marne ka kaam hai, right? That is the feeling. But you're not understanding. Again, that is a mental block. I think a lot of the students which I see, they're a mental block. What is the learning which you do? apart from tikda marne ka. You are learning, apart from accounting, what is happening there. You are learning maybe accounting standards, maybe auditing. All this is learning, standards of auditing. Khali tikda marna standard of auditing. Standard of auditing mein, you know, how do you plan, how do you document, how do you do, a lot of things are there. Accounting mein ek aap khali tikda marne ka dekhoge, to you will forget the accounting standard. Look at whether application of accounting standard is there or not. You will not get that opportunity. Forget this. Forget the subjects which are there. You are getting a chance to learn how businesses are run. Some businesses are run well, some are not run well. Some people are good, some people are bad. There may be, you know, systems. Somewhere there is Tally, somewhere there is SAP, somewhere there is Oracle. Kuch bhi hoga, whatever is there. Aaj koi bhi, tell me, in the biggest of big, whether it's an MBA or whatever, do you get a chance to go live to a business and see? Only in this particular profession, and that's absolutely invaluable. Let me tell you, and it's a holistic learning. If you have a mental block, then you will not learn. Main sirf tikde maar raha hu, to sikhoge nahi. If you have an open mind, then your learning is 360 degrees. You know, forget accounting side. I think accounting side sikhoge, auditing sikhoge, you'll learn companies act. In the same audit, you'll learn direct tax, indirect tax, and what do you call business system processes. It's a holistic thing. It depends on us. When you're doing an audit, service tax return kaise bhara hua hai, it's not only audit. There are so many paraphernalia. And you've got, you know, what do you call, without any responsibility. See, the responsibility is of your partner, of your principal, of your chartered accountant. Or kahin aise life mein, believe me, after 20 years, you'll find this is not available anywhere else. And what you learn, practically, you'll never learn, you know, theoretically. I can share an example. How many of you have cleared BCom over here? I was, many of you. Of this, how many of you have taken maths in 11th, 12th? Okay, you remember the topics which were there in 11th, 12th? Just name. So now, good. These topics, I also learned when I was in 11th, 12th. Today you ask me, I just know the topic. I don't know what is underlying that topic. So formula tha, used to mug the formula and crack the problems, right? Nothing else. Now you look at, I'll give another perspective. I went for my first audit during my articleship in the first, you know, this thing. Honestly, I didn't know what I was doing. Why I'm saying? In hindsight, I'm saying. Not at that point only. First time I just did the tikda marne ka job mein kiya hai. I went, luckily, mera naseeb acha tha. Second year also I was sent to the same audit. There was a topic, you know, there was inventory valuation ka kaam aaya. Maine dekha, are, by the time, possibly somewhere I would have read AS2. The time AS2 was there. Okay, how do you value inventories? Then there's a concept cost of market value, which is a cost of net reserve value, which is lower. So I started putting those concepts, what I was reading theoretically, to the practical this thing. And those fundamentally, those started getting embedded in me. Today, after 30 years, I have not done an audit for last number of years. Now, if you ask me any basic principle of AS2, I can share with you. What method to use, what formula to use, etc., etc. You can do only FIFO, you cannot do LIFO, or you can do a weighted average. I have not done any audit. I have not read the standard. But if you ask me, after 25, 30 years also, why I can remember, you have done it practically. That gets embedded. Whatever work you do practically gets embedded in you. Nobody can remove it. Whereas derivative integration, if you don't practice, it'll go away. After a few years, you know, there's only a certain capacity of a human mind. So practical training is, dusra ye hai, kafi time, people generally have seen, keep on cribbing. Sir, mere yahan to sirf audit hai. Sir, mere yahan to sirf tax hai, right? That is the feeling you have. Mere yahan to sirf indirect tax hai. One thing understand, everybody is by and large doing only one particular thing. They are not doing, very rarely, I think one in a million person will be able to do an all-round practical training of the subjects. So you're not worse off. So grab the maximum, you know, learning which you can do out of your direct training. And what else you can learn? As I told you, you can learn direct tax, accounting, depending whatever you're doing, audit or tax. Auditing, service tax, company law, CB. I'll tell you how unfortunate the thing is. And from my own office, I'm sharing an example. And I'm ashamed, I can tell you. Some CA passed, and we are more of an audit firm, less of a tax firm. The person was doing an audit. She cleared her CA, and then I just asked, somehow some question came up. I said, Section 372 of Companies Act, the person was not aware. Why? Because practically she had not done that, in the sense, or maybe she had not applied her mind, superficially. Audit kiya bhi hoga, but what is 372A, what is Section 58A for Companies Act, a lot of things. Whatever you do, read the theory. My suggestion is you read theory. So if you are doing tax, pick up the tax book, and let me tell you, your learning will be in finding mistake. Whether, suppose you're doing a tax computation. Just giving an example. Read the taxation sections, etc., etc. Normally, kya hota hai, it is garbage in, garbage out. Pichla ye chal raha hai, wo chalao. The principal doesn't have time to whatever new changes have happened to put it to practice or to put it implement. Because he's doing, you know, a lot of things. So read whatever you're doing, whether it's direct, indirect tax, audit, accounting, jo bhi aap karte ho, padke usko. Whatever you are doing, whatever practical training you are doing, whatever area you are doing, put it to practice. You will be able to find out improvements also in what to do. It will be a win-win for the firm, and for you it will be a knowledge gain. Whatever, you know, work you do, keep notes thereof. In my office, I'll just give an example. The current results were as bad as the national average. Or maybe worse than the national average. So we introspected, we have a session also. The earlier result for the both groups were 10%. In my office, the result was 50% that time. And I should have been elated, but I was not elated. Because the balance 50% were not cleared, I felt all of them were brilliant students. So we had this session 6-8 months back also, again after this particular exams. That time I asked him, when the results were good, what was there? Sir, audit ka paper pura practical tha. And we got cracking because we were doing audits and we had kept notes, whether it's a bank audit or an insurance audit or whatever. I don't know what questions were asked. And practical experience, we started applying to the paper. Fat karke. And another warning. Final ka pura paper, or most of you are from final, will be more and more practical oriented. More and more practical oriented. In the sense, whether it is audit. What happened during that paper, the earlier exam? I think this was November. So May, you know, 13th, the audit paper, instead of asking specifically, you know, okay, what is this standard of auditing or what is this accounting standard, you know, they just converted into situation and asked the question. Same thing. And it was a googly where most of the people failed. It was a horrible result. The first group result was only 14% as against an average of 25-30%. The first group result was only 14%. Why? Because with theory ko thoda practical mein convert karke dal diya. And my warning to all the students here is, this is going to be more and more. Our focus at the institute is that all the subjects, as far as possible, will be making it practical, whether it is accounts, direct tax, indirect tax, or whatever. Wherever practicality is there, or whether it is company law, jo bhi hai. So better get geared up. Here again, one more problem will come, sir. Main to sirf audit kar raha hu, how do I know direct tax mein practical issues kya hai? Or vice versa, somebody is doing in direct tax, how do I know? So there I suggest to all my students that you do what is called in corporate sector, a buzzword is knowledge management. You do your own knowledge management. What do? All of you had to classes in firms, etc. You know people, somebody is in the audit firm, somebody is in tax firm, somebody is in service tax. Make groups thereof. Whatever practical issues are arising out of that. See, audit, I'll give an example. All of you know the age 21 consolidation. I'll tell you, there are so many practical issues which are not in the standard. Once you start applying those standards to practical thing, lot of practical nuances come out, which a person, unless he's doing it, only will come out. Similarly, in direct tax, whether it's a deemed dividend 14A or whether it is 222E or a 14A disallowance or whatever, there will be some practical issues, whether it's transfer pricing head, some may kuch na kuch, which is not there apparently on the theory. If you read it, you will not get it. If you have done it practically, you will get that. So, jo bhi kar rahe hain, aap group bana lo aapke. Matlab, direct tax, audit, indirect tax, 4-5 log milke. Have once in a month or once in 2 months, you know, just note down what are the practical issues to come up and share with everyone. That is called knowledge management. That is the only way. There's no other way where all of you in all these subjects can come up to that level. Each of you will be expert in one or two subjects, but not all. So do what I call knowledge management. Aap as it is, baki sab cheezon ke liye milte ho, movies jaane ke liye milte ho. Iske liye, you know, meet for this purpose. Coming to coaching classes, as I told you, why is only a 3% result where 80% or 70% of you doing close use classes? Have you introspected? Is there any reason? Have you introspected why people are failing despite the coaching classes? Just That is there, apart from that. Again, it is very, very, you know, I think, I don't know whether it will be insulting to you. Nahin, wo to theek hai, but that again are based on students. I have seen most of the students are doing things superficially or mechanically, if you say. Aaj subah nikle, ya matlab coaching class, it has become a sort of herd mentality. Jana hai to jana hai. See, when you go to a coaching, jo kaam karo, whether articleship karo, coaching class karo, uska pura absorb fully out of it. You are not absorbing. Going to a coaching class, what should be the endeavor? A, suppose ek topic kara rahe, say amalgamation, ya maybe what a consolidation. The fact that this topic has been done, you should have mastery of the topic once you have done a coaching class. So what do? When the topic is going on, understand. If you don't understand, ask questions. Why are you giving the money to those people? I don't know. Of course, I'm told some of the classes are 1200, 1400 students. And despite that, they are able to take questions. But fine, let them be able to take questions. So ask questions if you don't understand. Second is practice separately. Jo bhi topic coaching class ho raha hai, you should be expert of that. Ek reading aapki ho jayegi, but subject to your expertise. Don't do it mechanically. You will find it insulting, but I'm telling you my observation. Or tabhi bhi wahan pe bhi WhatsApp chal raha hoga, baki sab chal raha hoga. Concentrate. Whatever work you do articleship, concentrate. Do studies, concentrate. Do coaching class, concentrate. Whoever is your professor, understand. If you don't understand, side mein jaake wapis, maybe when I said 2 hours of study, you may study that only, what has been taught in the coaching class. Uska padhai karo. Study that, ask questions, be absolutely master of that particular topic. Is it agreeable? You can do that. Because it is absolutely unbelievable for me why, you know, people fail despite doing coaching class. I'll tell you, during my time, I did coaching class for accounts in the inter, not for final. Because final mein 5-6 topic tha. Inter mein, what was the objective? A, practice, clarity, so that by the time you hit the exams, you finish all that subject. And final mein, I did coaching class for operation research and costing. Because operation research, I never used to understand what was there. We used to go to a coaching class called Usha classes. I don't know, Naushad would recollect. We had a professor, Bala. He was a person who was a practitioner of operation research in a company, Blue Star. So OR, if you just read, I'm not getting it. But then once you understand the background to it, what is OR, and you start then reading, it makes a hell lot of difference. So concentrate, understand what is going on, and be a master of the topic at that particular point of time. That is one. Second, as rightly said by a student here, CA, you know, unfortunately, not exactly CA, but I'm saying, what has happened in life is you have been brought up in the culture of maybe during a school, college, etc. What I call a spoon feeding. Coaching class is doing the spoon feeding. CA, see, you take it as a tool, don't take it as spoon feeding. That objective of coaching class has to be good practice, good clarity, good fundamentals, etc., whatever, but not as a spoon feeding. The moment it is spoon feeding, you're gone, you'll not pass your CA exam. So how do you distinguish, you know, CA means you have to apply your mind. And again, I'll share that example. I'll give an example of my first audit, that AS2 example. First time I went, I didn't know what I did. Second year I went, again, there was difficulty in understanding the concept, the AS2 concept, what is cost, what is NRV, etc. But one, you have to break the head. You know, CA ke liye dimag pe you have to put some pressure, what is this thing, and then try to relate. Or when I did my first audit, bank audit, I didn't understand what an LC is or a bank guarantee is. Maybe that time you may consult some of our seniors, but you have to push yourself, you have to push your mind, you have to push your head. So all these are, you know, side support systems are available to you, classes or whatever, but your own self-study, nobody can, you know, you have to do that. So, you know, itna usme wo nahi hona chahiye ki apne dependency, ki aapko nikama bana de. Coaching class should not make you, I would say, absolutely, you cannot do anything on your own. So CA means you'll have to do, you know, once you get out of the, once you become a CA. Today, there are so many CAs, unfortunately, why they are not able to do well? Because they would have passed through the coaching class culture, but practically they have not done self-study. that application of mind has to be there. This is okay, this is a situation. So whether you are doing your own practice or whether you're going to a company in industry for a job, unless you do that, only then you'll be successful. You'll get a degree. But if you're not done things on your own, how to crack a problem or so, you know, which takes efforts. And right now you are in the 3 years, you don't have much of a burden. You can push your mind, try to understand and do better. As I told you, they don't cover many topics. They'll just leave it, don't leave. And generally we have got a habit in issue, jo chi topic nahi hai, usi topic mein question puchenge. Another thing, of all of you are like my sons and daughters. My son also is a CA, and what I'm telling you, I've told him also, and he practiced it also. You are going through three things in life: college, articleship, and classes, right? Right now for the CA exams. What is the priority? I believe by and large, except NM College, I think no other college is very, you know, gung-ho about the time or attendance. So college to sirf namesake hai. Second is your articleship, and third is the classes. It's a life is a balance, you know, in the sense you have to balance between these two. So which is be a more priority if a situation arises where you have to decide a priority? For example, say you're an audit firm and you're supposed to go on an audit, outstation audit. Again, I'm telling out of experience, I used to get many students, sir, hum log nahi jayenge. Kyun? Classes. That time I thought possibly unko study karna, but then I realized it is not so much of the study. It is so much of the, you know, lot of people coming from outstation who are so much on the money. Each class I lose $500. That was the mindset. If I miss one class, miss outstation audit, suppose I go for 15-day outstation audit, I lose ₹500 per day or whatever it is, so and so money. Because I paid for the classes, I'm not attending, I'm losing that money. I can only share with you, if you don't go for an outstation audit, you are losing crores and crores of valuable experience. It's completely immeasurable. Second example, say you are doing it in a tax firm, peak period, 30th September hai, yeah, whatever, indirect tax firm, or direct, indirect, whatever, there are peak periods. During that time, forget classes. If you get immersed in that work, the learning which will get out of it will be completely, you know, and this I'll share, my son, I gave him the same advice. He was in a, not in my firm, he was in a different firm, larger firm. He used to be out for 1 month on an audit in Khopoli and somewhere, then for 15 days in Jamnagar, etc., etc. I only gave him one blank check. I said, you forget your class. When I say forget, jab tak ho sakta hai karo. When you're in Bombay, depending on your work schedule, but priority has to be your work. Because that learning, and again, not from working. See, people feel generally mindset, bachcho mein kya hota hai, wo to kaam kara rahe. You should not be bothered. Your, that work is your learning. What you're working is your learning. I gave only that advice. If you want, you do those classes second time, or you hire tuitions later on. I'll give the money. Don't bother. I gave a blank check. If tum uska mind mein tension hi mat rakho, you are missing so and so classes. He could attend only hardly 50% of, and I think some of you may be knowing him over here, or if you can verify, he was able to attend hardly 50% of his classes. He was a CPT student. He was doing his articleship after CPT, earlier time. He cleared his IPCs in the first attempt. He cleared his CA final in the first attempt. And comfortably. He didn't get a rank. That's a different thing. He didn't get a... See, life mein after some time, your rank or your profile, it looks good. But what is going to help you in your lifetime is your experience. And experience will be coming by work. Aaj tum, theek hai, rank does make a difference. I'm not saying that, okay, for your jobs and all. But how many people will get a rank? Not more than 50? The experience will be your lifetime experience. You know, you'll be able to... Or aaj bhi, jabhi, see, last 2 years, the job market has been bad, all of you know. Have you observed that people who have done good training, have they got jobs or not? By and large, they have got jobs. Who have not got the jobs? People who have not done proper training. Maybe, kisne dummy kiya hai, kisne kuch kiya hai. By and large, I'm saying, little bit exceptions here and there. There are always exceptions to the rule. But anybody who has done proper training has got good jobs, let me tell you, and they're progressing well. In fact, one of my son's colleague, he was lucky to join an investment bank. Aajkal investment bank mein job nahi hai. After 1.5 years, getting to another job at 50 lakh remuneration. Can you believe? After 1.5 years. In today's time. He's lucky. Everybody is not so lucky. My son's colleague. My son is not getting 50 lakh. He's already, he's much lesser. But 50 lakh job in these bad times, after 1.5 years. 1.5 years he struggled, you know, was there with the investment, he was lucky. Achha kaam karo, your work will take you miles, that much I can guarantee you. If you believe my 30 years of grey hair, and even if you don't pass your CA exam, believe me, no, the CA nahi ho, aap inter CA bhi honge, your value will be humongous. If you know your job properly, in any way. In fact, nowadays we don't hardly, you know, in between time, aise tha, we hardly used to get CA, inter CA, this thing. People who are appearing for finals 10-15 times se diya hai. So you'll get good, you know. So give, when a situation arises, give priority to work, not from the work perspective, from a learning perspective. The amount of learning which you learn on an outstation audit, you cannot learn on a domestic audit. That's what I can tell you, on local city audit. Because you're fully involved 12 hours, 15 hours, you know, a lot of other things. So don't miss that opportunity. Then we come to the study methods. Normally what do? We only read. So when I'm reading, I'll just read. How many of you prepare notes over here? Reasonably good. Whoever balances not doing it, start preparing notes. When you read, you know, because on the exam day, you'll not be able to read those 500 pages. So if ek chapter mein, maybe one para, maybe 10 lines, maybe 20 bullet lines, which will be able to, you can then extrapolate. You're noted, jotted down those lines, that one line on the exam day you read and you'll be able to reproduce one paragraph. So that has to be your objective. So systematically, methodically start jotting down. And write it by your own hands. Very important. Don't use a computer, don't use somebody else's note. And write it in your own original thought. Don't just reproduce what that line is. So that will bring in an understanding part of it also. One is the mechanical part. Jo line likhi hai, wohi likh dunga. If you understand it and then write, it will help you extrapolate during the examination for the paragraph or the full page. And do it systematically, methodically, how you want to do it. Use highlighters or you want to write in your study material next or in a separate note. But do it very, very systematically. So during the exam days, you will only refer to that. Maybe reference ke liye, your main book will be available with you. Balance is that. Second, if you want, use some memory techniques. I am not an expert. For that, you'll have to go to some other professor. Possibly in your classes, they'll be teaching you how to remember certain things. You know, some acronyms, something. I'm not an expert on that, so I will not. Do all the topics and subject. Don't leave anything for option. I think somebody's got a habit, you know, generally apna BCom time pe ye chhod diya, fir bhi pass ho gaye. CA mein you will be proven wrong if you leave anything. Jo cheez aapne nahi kiya wohi exam mein puchhenge. You can take it for a guarantee. So don't leave anything for, you know, as an option. What are the two key things we need for a CA, who's a successful CA, you know, even if you clear the exam? Strong fundamentals and cracking speed during the examination. I'm saying, forget later on, even as a CA student, what is required? Very, very strong fundamental of the subject. And cracking speed in writing in those 3 hours. So there's two things. So you need to understand the concepts. Clearly, it will help in solving complex. Why abhi, jaise apne classes ki baat ki, despite doing classes, why do you fail? Mechanical. You don't understand. Understand the concept. Any googly, anybody will put in the exam, you can crack it. And that level of expertise is required in the exams. CA final, you'll need almost expert knowledge in all the subjects. Somewhere there's working knowledge, but as far as the final CA is concerned, it is expert knowledge in almost all the subjects. So your fundamentals, the moment your fundamentals are clear, kuch bhi googly dala, you'll be able to answer it. Two things. Second is practice. Fundamental clear, second you practice enough number of problems. So even if they give a twist, generally get a twist aa jata hai, right? Do you agree, like some of the, if you see the past papers, there are googlies and twists. If your fundas are good, you'll be able to, you know. Mugging up won't help. That's why I'm saying understanding. You do whatever you want. We want to make some tables, flowcharts, diagrams in your, you know, format which helps you. Again, I'm mentioning, say for example, Companies Act. Suppose you become a CA. Assume you are in a tax firm. And you get into a job, and somebody asks you, in companies like, you know, oh, there are acceptance of deposit, 58A ka kya issues, hai, kya, whether we can accept deposit, you will be flumbering, sir, maine kiya hi nahi hai, but practice me. So that answer will not help. So, suppose you're a tax firm and you're doing Companies Act, reading Companies Act, understand which are the critical sections, which not only for the exams, in a subsequent career also will be thrown, you know, there are some critical sections, even same way for tax, assuming you're an audit firm, And tax, where there are five things, you know, you should be able to sort of reel off. I don't practice tax, but I know what are the live issues, whether it's transfer pricing, domestic transfer pricing, 14A deemed even, maybe anything more, four, five things in tax, either expert in international tax. You should be aware. And while studying, you relate. See, you, the question will be, suppose you're on a tax firm, you're not on any Companies Act. So how will you relate? Try to understand, visualize. When I'm reading 58A, what does it mean? Visualize the situation of an audit. Section 372A, try to get a balance sheet and try to put some numbers there. For example, if you're doing 370, there are limits. 60% of paid up capital and free reserves, or 100% of free reserves. If you've not done that practically, when you're studying, try to, you know, do it with a practical this thing. Try to visualize and do it. Again, that will get embedded in your mind. So do that. Many times, you know, actually I used to omit theory. During our time, we could answer full practical questions. But nowadays, theory we push a practical question. So don't omit theory in the practical question. And refer to the BAR Acts also. If it is Income Tax Act or whatever, Companies Act, it will give you a lot of, you know, sort of, it may be difficult to understand first. But ek time, do time, teen time, try to read the BAR Acts wherever possible. Next is writing practice. Many times you come across questions, you know, I was able to even only answer 80 marks of questions at the whole time. Why does it happen? Because you are studying for 2 months, 4 months, writing practice will go nahi hoti hai. I have failed in my economics paper in FY VCOM because I couldn't write. FY, luckily there was 80, so I cleared. But unfortunately, you have 80 nahi, except exemption if you get more than 60. So you have a writing practice before, few days before you can start writing. Your hands are not moving. And in the exam, you have to get cracking. A, knowledge, fundamental. Second is writing. So few days before the exam, start writing practice. So that you start flowing. Second, even practical problems, generally I've seen people, kya bolta bhi, during leave period, you just read the answers, right? Do you solve the practical questions? Oh, maine coaching class mein kar liya, and what do you do finally? You just read through the answers. That will not help. You need to solve on your own. Need to solve on your own. 3 hours of this time, you need to allocate, you know, marks wise. In first hour, you will be able to complete between 35 to 40 marks. Same way next hour, third hour, track the time. Assuming koi question mein aap atake, generally first question googly rehta hai. Leave it at the end of that. Suppose assuming it is say 35 marks and you allocated 30 minutes for it. After 30 minutes, leave it. थोड़ा जगह छोड़ दो, एक दो पेजेस सप्लीमेंट, जितना भी यू एस्टिमेट हाउ मच यू विल रिक्वायर फॉर कंप्लीटिंग दैट आंसर, गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. इट्स गोइंग टू टेक टाइम. एक दो मिनट में हो रहा है तो कंप्लीट कर लो. 30 का 32 मिनट्स इज नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम, बट 30 का अगर 45 मिनट्स होने वाला है, इट विल ब्रिंग प्रेशर एट योर लेटर क्वेश्चन. सो लीव दैट. इफ इट इज गोइंग टू टेक मच मोर टाइम, लीव सम स्पेस, वन और टू पेजेस ऑफ व्हाट एवर इज रिक्वायर्ड, एंड गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. जो पेन से आप लिखने वाला एग्जाम, हैव यू राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस विद सेम पेन. स्मॉल थिंग्स बट मेक अ डिफरेंस. Come to revision. Whatever you study in a week, revise in the next, at the end of the weekend. A lot of time to revise chapter in a fast track before beginning new chapter that we discussed. Make sure that whatever you study can be thoroughly revised on the exam days, as one cannot remember everything. As I mentioned, you make notes, bullet points, each topic wise, subject wise, that you will refer to it at the time of revision. Then what are the, even in the practical subject, what are the key things which you will practice? You know, what are the complicated issues or whatever which you will need to have a run through? Because you will not be able to practice all the problems before the exam day. You identify amongst this thing, I will practice so and so. Balance work, I will be able to crack without the practice. That also you identify. For practical subject, as I told you, conceptual clarity. I just remember an example of, say, maybe marginal costing. One is you do things mechanically. Second is understand the concept. Bugging matko, I think now I need to rush. I already got an intimation. I think this will be circular. Ha, concentration. I'll just spend few minutes. This is important. As I told you, your mobile has to be off when you're studying. For those hours, only lunchtime, break time. Don't be a slave technology, make it a slave. Discipline, whatever. Computers, internet browsing, all off. If you're studying at home, interruption by guests. You cannot say no. My advice is best is go to your college or wherever nearby college, reading room, whatever is available. It could be any reading room. Study there, it will help. Today is the age of socializing, you know, you have got various groups. So you'll be attending, even during articleship and all, you need to draw a line somewhere. Today somebody's birthday party is there, movies, this, that. Everything in limit is good. I'm not saying don't do anything. Have a limit. Your focus has to act. Whenever a person comes to me for articleship, I say, think 3 years as a jail, you are in a jail. Only two things, articleship and study. Articleship and study, you know, practical training, nothing else. Balance, ek do do cheez, man behalane ke liye kabhi ko thak gaye, movie dekh liya, ye dekh liya. Nowadays what has happened is these, we don't realize how much time we spend. Aaj iski birthday party, aaj uski birthday party hai. Draw a line till what level are you going to attend? Your immediate close circle, because circles of bahut hai apne. There will be no end. So socializing, limited. I would not say do it limited. You can't study when there is a TV running in your house. No? Somebody else is watching TV, somebody else is listening to music or baju mein koi kya Diwali ka patake jal rahe hai, ya apne, say maybe during Ganpat, a lot of loudspeakers going on. You can't study. So you go to a place. Meditation can help, you know, your breathing. Depending on your religion, you're doing Gayatri Mantra, you're doing Navkar Mantra, whatever. That will help. That will be able to give you a lot of concentration when you're stressed out. When I was studying in the night before sleeping, I used to do a mantra, you know, a number of times and then used to sleep. So din bhar ka jo fatigue used to go out, you sleep well, few hours and then you. Knowledge management we discussed. Library we discussed. This is just for your hard work is required. Attitude, very important. In my belief, our CA exams, more than anything else, is a test of your mental strength. And I'll give a live example, very recent example. This current result which you saw, 3%. My office also results were bad, but luckily we had one rank holder. Luckily, I'm saying. Why? How many marks did she get in accounts? Any guesses? Exact 40. Exact 40. One is possibly whatever grace mark institute had given, and the fact that she had scored very well in the other subject, possibly just to pass both sums also should have got her. So if your paper is tough, it is tough for everyone. I have seen in tough papers generally you clear, and in easy papers you get lower marks. And it has been experienced with me also. So when a paper is tough, don't get bogged down. It is tough for everyone. Go with a smiling face, okay, next paper I'll crack. Generally, you have depression. Okay, wait, does that happen? Don't put down. It's a test of your mental strength. Automatically, it happens. So, be physically fit in the sense, assuming as I traveled, a break time, you take a nap, you can take a walk, whatever suits you. Physical, you know, fitness also is important. That will make your mind work better. So at least have some walking, this thing. Answering techniques, I think I will. Misinterpretation of questions, I think that is important. Especially ISKA. Many people fail in ISKA. In my own office, couple of years back when we were analyzing the results, and luckily, you know, kya hota hai, if you have 2-3 years of people coming with you, so, yes, subject ka baat nikla. So, one of the girls, I can name her also, Divya Ahuja. She mentioned, she had failed in ISKA in the earlier attempt. Next attempt, she cleared. And what was the reason? She said, you know, number one, of course, she was looking at the study material. Second is, people jump to the answer. See, same question, you feel it is, you know, a particular answer is there. It is not the answer, it is some other answer. So, read carefully before jumping. This is a typical problem in ISKA that the answer which you write is not the answer which is required. Why? Because in your speed, in your haste, you jump to a conclusion that this is what is expected. So read properly, thoroughly, and don't misinterpret the question, especially if ISKA. Other things I think I'm... do the attend the mock test, very important. They got a system of mock test. Either you do it on your own, or Institute also is giving this platform of mock test. You know, whatever you have studied, that at least you'll come to, you'll get the answer sheet corrected, where you're going wrong, where you're weak, you can work on that. Most important, to stop the blame game. You are responsible for your result. If you're not passing, introspect, where, I'll give my example. I failed miserably in my IPCC, or my inter during that time. I got in three subjects, I gave only one group and all were below 30. So, ek mahina to I started introspecting whether I'm fit to be a CEO or not. And then, you know, after that 1 month of, I would say, introspection, I came to a conclusion. First is the determination. Like, what the hell is this CEO? I'll do it. That is that determination has to come, especially if you have failed. Second, khali wo jusse se kaam nahi chalega. You have to analyze where you're going. I'll tell you where. During our times, we didn't have mobiles and all, 30 years back. I started analyzing what was wrong. First and foremost, I was studying in my house. Second, first 1 or 2 hours in the morning, I used to go through the financial newspapers. And the stock prices used to come, I used to go through them. I never used to trade. And I never realized that I was spending hours in, you know, looking at the stock price. I used to get a kick out of the movement of stock prices. Not trading, just looking at them. The way you're spending time on your mobiles and all, I used to get a kick out at that time. So one has to introspect when one is going wrong. There will be various things. So this time, it may be something else for you. But introspect where you're going wrong and start correcting them. So no blame game, you are responsible. Don't be under pressure when you're giving the exam. You know, pressure of the family, generally confident, but during the examination time, become nervous. A lot of you become nervous during the exam time. No reason. See, question is, you won't build up an expectation gap. I say, you may say, to hell with everyone. I am there, pass hoga to theek. Ek wo kya bolta hai? Ek wo maula ke jaise you have to give this exam. This is okay, I'll crack it, I'll do my best. Kya hoga, worst comes failure. Usse to aur kuch jyada koi phansi ka bandha nahi lagne wala hai. Wo jo mental pressure hai, the psychological pressure you have to be out of, which you only can do it. Be confident, don't be overconfident. At the same time, don't be nervous. So I'm saying many of you, because I've seen some of in my close circles also. Forget about the expectations of the family. I say, ek time fail bhi hua to koi heavens are not going to fall. After you become a CA, after a few, nobody has asked me in which attempt have you become a CA. Many of the life failures are people who did not realize how close they were to success when they gave up. Thomas Alva Edison. I'll just quickly run through this particular 2 minutes just to give you some. So those who have failed, I think a lot of people raise their hands.
After being cut from his high school basketball team, he went home, locked himself in his room and cried. He wasn't able to speak until he was almost 4 years old, and his teachers said he would never amount to much. Was demoted from her job as a news anchor because she wasn't fit for television. Fired from a newspaper for lacking imagination and having no original ideas. At age 11, he was cut from his team after being diagnosed with a growth hormone deficiency, which made him smaller in stature than most kids his age. At 30 years old, he was left devastated and depressed after being unceremoniously removed from the company he started. High school dropout, whose personal struggles with drugs and poverty culminated in an unsuccessful suicide attempt. A teacher told him he was too stupid to learn anything, and that he should go into a field where he might succeed by virtue of his pleasant personality. Rejected by Decca recording studios, who said, "We don't like their sound, they have no future in show business." His first book was rejected by 27 publishers. His fiancée died, failed in business, had a nervous breakdown, and was defeated in 8 elections. If you've never failed, you've never tried anything new.
So this is all the people like me who have failed. I think life is not the end of it, failure. I think, I'll tell you, if you take it positively, the amount of strength it will give in your life to overcome any, you know, failures later on. See, it's part and parcel of our life, failures. For example, Sachin Tendulkar, the failures between his 99th century to 100th century, he failed so many number of times. He couldn't cross his 100th century. But if he failed earlier, had he gone under pressure of the, you know, society, of the country, he would never got his 100th century. So don't be under pressure. General examination tips, I think I'll leave it for you to read. Only thing, don't use your SMS language in the answer papers. It's a sure shot receipt for disaster for your marks. How many of you inadvertently use that language in the answer papers? I don't know. Are you careful? And I think sleep properly during the exam days. Normal sleep, I don't say extra sleep. If you're sleeping for 6 hours, 7 hours normally, you need to be absolutely fresh for your, you know, exams. This will be getting, the presentation of the paper also has to be good. It is not only what you write, enough practice, whereas your accounting practical, you know, subject, or it's a theory subject, your untidiness, all those things will not, you know, help. The differentiator will be if you have, you know, written your answers properly, presented it well, it will give you more marks. I'm not getting into subject wise suggestions. This you can have a look. Iska, you want to? It's there, you can read it, because we won't have time for question answers, so I just want to rush through. These are some important, useful. Iska, at the request of Mayur Bhai, chairman of the HR committee, go through this subject once a week, because many students have a negative opinion on the subject. Constant touch of the subject is very much required. This again, I have not done this paper. This is again experience sharing from my own office, and I'm sharing with you. Write papers to clear your concept, you know, write the mock papers. Getting blank in this subject is a common thing which I hold. But when you start writing, the flow will come. You should include relevant diagrams, tables, rough sketch, etc. Use technical words in your answers. Most importantly, read questions carefully, thoroughly, properly. It is observed that the students jump to some answer which is not based on the question. One question, you know, you feel the answer is so and so. Actually, it is not so. I'm not able to explain because it's not my subject, but this is what the general impression from the examiners we are getting, and from my own, you know, office colleagues. And read the study material. How many of you are reading the study material first? I think most of you are reading the study material. Very few. Okay. So read the study material. These are the useful links of the institute. I won't go through the motivational video. I would just want you to refer to Jessica Cox's video. It's available on YouTube. A girl without her hands, she can fly a plane. If a girl without hands can fly a plane, she can do everything. Can we give the CA exam successfully?
Yes.
So, I think we'll spend some time for questions. Somebody, first question I'll answer, which was the question which was the trigger point for this whole session, is the institute does not reduce marks. We don't manage results downwardly. Upwardly, yes. How much grace marks to give, that is a question. But never in our life, I can challenge, is anybody been given any marks for? Yeah. I'll tell you, it's a very, very cumbersome process. There's humongous amount of maker checker, you know, there. But even then, it's a human, you know, this thing. There could be some errors. I'm not saying in verification, light, small errors, but there is never a downward revision. I got a call a couple of exams back from Surat saying that, you know, somebody called for the, now you can call for answer sheets. How many of you are calling for answer sheets? Very few. Those who have failed, call your answer sheets and compare it to the suggested answers. That's another thing I forgot to tell you. Call for the photocopies of our answer sheets, whoever has given the exams and not succeeded, compare it to the suggested answers. That is the ideal. See where you're going wrong. See what marks you have got.
So I
came, the one person, you know, called up saying that initially the marks were 43 and then 26 has come. And I can share in what condition that happens. We, the process, initially each examiner is given 20 sample papers. Based on his assessment sampling, if he's doing his job properly at that point of time, another set is given of 200, 300 questions. When those after evaluation it comes back, again a sample is verified out of that, whether he is assessed properly. You know, what happens is, say, Nilesh is very strict, Mayurbhai is liberal, same question paper. So that type of moderation also happens. So suppose I have given very, very low across all the 200, 300 papers I have done, and Mayurbhai is given liberally. So that will not be reduced. But at least if I have been very, very conservative, it will be slightly, the head examiner does all this moderation. A. So what would have happened in that 43 to 26 is, somebody has done it very, very loosely, the marking. The sample would have gone, because that fellow has marked it, and then the head examiner would have not given balanced papers to him, but given it to somebody else and would have marked properly. Second, when the 300 papers also comes back after verification, assuming that somebody has done a proper sample job, from that sample also, again, if somebody sees that the marking has not been done consistently, the whole 300 papers will be reassessed. So, tabhi bhi ho sakta hai. Kisne mark likha hai, to pure 300 reassess kar raha hai, baki kisse. So, these are the processes which goes on. But never will anybody be given, will be failed despite passing. So in this process, this is a process of, you know, verification. There are a lot of maker checker. Huh? Despite that, some human errors acceptable. So this is one I think I mentioned, which is a trigger point. Any other questions? No, nothing of that sort. No. The question is, if the paper is coming easy, the checking will be tough. No, that is not the case. Reverse is true. And I'll give an example. I don't know whether I should be sharing this openly, but now since RTI is there, you can get your answer, but I can share openly also. Accounts paper, last time. This one. Very bad, I think most of them, you know, almost 9 marks the grades were given. The head examiner suggested only 5 marks grades. The committee gave 9 marks grades. And I think somebody can verify. If you call for your answer books, why I'm sharing openly? So reverse is true. As I told you, it is never sort of cut down marks. And there, see, today what has happened is the system has become so huge. We have got about 80,000, more than 80,000 students appearing for final. At IPCC, it's 2.5 lakh students. And no examiner gets more than 300 papers. So there is no way somebody can call up all these and say, "Isko tough correct karo, ye." It's out. So that all is, you know, generally not done. But the impression happens. But reverse is always true. In a tough paper, you'll get good marks, you'll pass. That much I can, you know, give you a comfort, because you'll get some grace marks. Assuming you attempted it. In a tough paper, if you're not attentive, to jo usko dena to bhi nahi de sakte. Isko easily correct karna, you cannot give. So that's why positive attitude is important. Yeah, Mirvi. Pardon?
I'm really confused for articles.
I'm not hearing you properly.
I'm really confused for articles. Should I go for B.Com or medical?
Let's talk about the exams.
No, he says related to his learning also articleship. See, I'll say, if you want to make money, go to the Big Four, stipend is good. The life is miserable since you know the working hours there. If you want to go abroad and do an MBA or something, possibly that brand will help. If you want to learn, in my view, a mid-sized firm will be better. If you want to gain knowledge. In Big Four, what is happening is they're absolutely sort of structured in what you can learn. An article cannot do more than a certain thing, it's responsibility. Whereas in a mid-size and a small firm, if you're picking up, if you've got the courage in you, you'll be given responsibility, you can, and that from that responsibility you'll learn. You can do more work and more learning. So that will happen in a mid-size or a small firm. In a large firm, even if you're performing exceptionally well, you can go only to a certain level. You cannot do more than certain level, only a chartered accountant can do. The article cannot do. Whereas, which is not the case in a mid-size or small firm. So what is the objective? It will depend on that. Make money, go abroad, have a good brand, thappa. I got a question like this in Jaipur, I was addressing a student. Sir, can you help us in getting in before? I said, number one, institute cannot help. Number two, you understand the objective. If that girl from Jaipur, what is she going to do? Is depending on what her this thing is, she going to practice in Jaipur or in Rajasthan? What is the objective of going to a big four? So have your objective clear, what do you want to do ultimately? You know, post your this thing. Graduation? No, not required. Not
actually, I'm not even enrolled in graduation.
Not required. No, no. No, no, nothing of that. Graduation is not at all essential for CA. Post 12 you can do CA without doing a BCom. But I would suggest you do your BCom. Reason is, for a lot of the government jobs and all, later on, assuming you want to go somewhere, that graduation is compulsory. Not for CA, but for some other purpose in life, you may require, and you can do graduation like a breeze. If you're doing CA, it's a cakewalk. It's no big deal. So just for incidentally, your degree mil gaya apne ko. So do graduation not because of it required by CA, but for other purposes. Any other misconceptions, doubts?
Sir, student was obtained CA final number 3 attempt, and he has got 13 marks in SFM paper 2, credit financial management. So for his 10 marks, he has lost the first row. Otherwise, his aggregate is more than 1. He has asked for 35 copies, and on observation, he saw that in one of the questions of 10 marks, he has been awarded 0 marks.
Despite writing,
compared suggested, all the steps was correct, even the answer is correct.
This falls within the what I said, the human error. And which you can't do anything. I sympathize. I tell you, I'm pushing in the council. See, finally, it is, the situation is a lot of practicalities involved. I have been pushing. I come across a case, similar case in tax. A girl from a very large firm in Bombay. She came with me a tax paper where she had written the answer. The answer was correct. One or two cases happened like this. And she had failed. And she was not crying, but I could see her plight. And I'm trying to push in the council. I took it up with the examination committee that we need to look at this case. Of course, it entails huge paraphernalia. You know, right now the rule is we will not reassess the marks. As I told you, they are human effort. It is just misfortune that the person, see, that's why we are trying to bring in more accountability at the examiner level. In between, a couple of years back, I got a video of a lady correcting the CA final paper in the local train. I immediately sent that to the exam committee. I said, identify who this lady is and see that she's sucked out of the, you know, evaluation system. That how can they take so, you know, it's the life of so many students who is seeing. So these are, my sympathies are with you, that's the only thing. Till the time we change the system, till that time we cannot do anything. We are pushing for it, we have to work out the modalities or logistics. But these are very, very rare. This is not a routine thing. That's why I brought in that human error. This is your part of it.
So, is there something like certain topics have been allotted certain marks? Example, Goa will always come for 40 marks in the paper.
Yeah, that is there. The whole marking system is there. It's part of my presentation. I didn't go through it. Which topic will be the allocation, the weightage is there, which you should have a look at it when you start studying. Don't do a trend analysis. See, trend analysis is different in the sense, you know, what exactly was asked in that particular thing. But broad, you know, that allocation is there. Okay, OR will be 40 marks, that will be there. But don't do trend analysis. For example, the May exam, a lot of things were asked from the past papers and, you know, study material. It didn't happen in November. So people who did only that, it backfired.
हिंदी
वालों को कुछ आर्टिकल सी मिलती नहीं है. मीन समझाते हैं अगर बोलते
हैं कि हिंदी मीडियम ऑफ किया हुआ मैंने, तो गेट आउट.
मैं सिर्फ एक ही एग्जांपल दे सकता हूँ. हमारे यहाँ द क्वेश्चन इज वेदर द मीडियम मेक्स अ डिफरेंस ऑन आर्टिकल शिप एक्सेट्रा. ओनली मीडियम विल नॉट मेक अ डिफरेंस. एंड आई कैन शेयर एन एग्जांपल. वी हैड अ person called Praveen Daga in our office. He came from Calcutta, speaking only Hindi, but one of the most brightest during his student time also, became a CA and currently is a partner in a Bangalore office. And he is a Hindi medium student. Hindi mein, even the concepts, he was one of the good trainers in the office also. He used to explain, his fundas were so clear on various subjects that he used to take training sessions in the office during his articleship also. So Hindi, English, zaruri nahi hai, aapka funda kitna clear, if you are good, you will make it. But there is a slight disadvantage, whether I admit. People prefer English speaking. Because apne, unfortunately, jitne bhi report writing, ye wo sab hai, thoda uspe, toh aap wo English hai, course kar lo na, kya badi baat hai. Indo-American, ye wo sab, there are many, you know, societies which very reasonable cost mein aapko English speaking ho jayega, usme koi badi baat hai kya? Aaj samjho ki apne ko lag rahi weakness hai, weakness ko attack karo na, khatam karo usko. Why we want to... Solution, jaise, problem ka solution dekho. Hai problem, solution dekho.
Good morning only, I have heard this from one of my friends that regulation 39 of the Chartered Accountants Act give them the power to curb the marks. I have not verified it, but
I'll tell you, so it says moderation of marks. We have got powers to moderate the marks. But today under RTI, I told you, you are getting an answer copy.
If somebody has done that, that error is separate. Nobody can challenge an error. But as some you have got, somebody has evaluated you 50 marks and then they say, if you want to control the result, I'll do it 40, we cannot do it. And I have talked to number of presidents, even before my council, in our own office, we got a past president in our office and number of other people. The feedback, not a single time any marks has been cut down. Not a single time. That power is there, what you're saying. Does it make a difference? Mayur Bhai is asking a question. Does it make a difference if I give exams from a small town? Absolutely no difference. And I'll tell you the reason also what happens. I'll tell you the reason. See, generally impression kya hota hai? Suppose I'm giving from Bombay, most of the people are English speaking, good, intelligent, etc. If I go to a place, say Bharuch, or for example, aur bhi dur kahin pe kya, Gandhidham, in Kutch. Wahan pe level of students may be, or Rajasthan or wherever, Bihar mein jaake, or Bihar, best. So, main Patna mein jaake agar exam dunga, wahan pe level of education is low, level of English is low, etc., etc. Right? That is the impression which is there. Completely wrong. I'll tell you what happens. आप लोग आंसर लिख लेते हो, आपके रोल नंबर होते हैं, रोल नंबर निकाल देते हैं आपके उसमें से फ्रॉम योर पेपर एंड अनदर कोडिंग कम्स ऑन दैट पेपर, अनदर कोड पुट, सो दैट फ्रॉम कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी, आई विल टेल यू द सिस्टम्स वर्स बी लेड डाउन बाय फोर फादर्स आर सो सुपर्ब, ओनली थिंग विद द इंक्रीजिंग नंबर्स नाउ वी यूज़ टू नीड टू यूज टेक्नोलॉजी मोस्ट, वी आर यूजिंग यू दिस कोडिंग इज एंड you know, computerized. So whatever roll number, you'll get a different code. The different code will be put on your paper. And again, it will be serial number. So once the number is changed, it will not be in sequence. Say, aapne Patna se diya. Patna se samjho, there are 1,000 people who are given from Patna. Those papers will come, they'll be given a different code. And then it will be rearranged in the different code, in the seriatim. I don't know, are you able to get?
Yes.
So 1,000 papers of Patna, maybe 100 will go to Delhi, 100 will go to, I'm saying separately, not even the same order. Something will go to Chennai, somebody will go to Calcutta, somebody will go to Gandhidham, somebody will go to Bombay for verification. It will be completely lost in that whole this thing. It is renumbered.
3 years
mixed up. Huh. So it is renumbered and then again rearranged in that serium. So it doesn't make a difference. In my view, it doesn't make a difference. That's it. Finally, receipt for success. Again, this I'm lifting out Mr. Manoran's session. You need to have interest and passion. You have the intelligence, you need to tap into it. And you need to be completely involved. So again, this picture in my own this session, it's not going to be easy. But I'm telling you, it's going to be worth it if you go through the rough seas and overcome the, you know, these tides. I'll conclude with a Hindi shayari. I think a lot of people in the students like, for my Hindi friend here. Zindagi ki asli udaan abhi baki hai. Zindagi ke kahi imtihan abhi baki hai. अभी तो नापी है मुट्ठी भर जमीन आपने, अभी तो नापी है मुट्ठी भर जमीन आपने आपके आईपीसीसी, आगे अभी सारा आसमान बाकी है। सो मे गॉड ब्लेस यू एंड आई विश ऑल ऑफ यू सक्सीड, यू नो, वेरी वेरी सक्सेसफुल इन योर सी एग्जाम्स। थैंक यू।
I just request all of you to be there for one more minute. We need to thank him and thank him properly. So just wait for a minute.
Mayur, you would like to
meet? Friends, just couple of minutes, please. First of all, my heartfelt thanks to Nilesh Bhai. He instantly agreed when we met about 1 month before, and I told him that, you know, the CA results is only 3% and students are talking that there is a, you know, across the board marks cutting and whatnot. I said, then he said, you know, I think these are the myths which we need to clear. And the idea was to give you a guidance, a roadmap, how succeed. Friends, Naushad made a mention about the activities of the society. We have arranged a students' orientation course, which is coming up in the month of April, on 18th and 19th of April. This is specifically designed for the students who are entering the profession. In 2 days' time, you will be given the bird's eye view of all the subjects, including some of the tips to become a good chartered accountant. Secondly, we have a BCA journal, a very good magazine. Let me tell you that when I was studying, you know, my CA examinations, I used to prepare my text paper from the journal. And when I became a president of the society, then I came to know how much effort is going in, you know, preparing this journal month after month. Each and every page is reviewed. So you must go through the, you know, latest development, latest case laws, tribunal, high court, supreme court, from the institute journal, from the BCA journal. Very subsidized rate we have, you know, giving for the students, just 500 rupees for the entire year subscription, as against, you know, 1200 for the members. So please subscribe to the BCA journal. We have one very interesting workshop coming up on 5th of April on business etiquettes. Friends, that is, you must be learning from your GMCS, but let me tell you this, this also would be a very, very interesting workshop, only 3 hours workshop on Saturday afternoon. Please do join that. One very interesting, every year we have this Jal Dastu's annual Students' Day. It's a Students' Day organized by the student. Raj is here, you know, who is one of the active member. We have active student study circle running every month religiously on the first Friday. We have a student study circle where students make presentations. And the, you know, participants are students. The member would be chairing that particular meeting. And you would be surprised that, you know, students are discussing right from the international economics to the international taxation, FEMA, service tax, VAT, accounting standards. So I invite all of you to join that study circle. It's very, very interesting forum, and you must make a, you know, maximum out of it. Let me tell you, friends, 2 months, how many of you are appearing for the May exams? Very good. After listening to Nilesh Bhai, I am sure that you all will be very confident. And let me tell you, 2 months is a more than sufficient time for preparing your exams. I know, you are laughing. Do mahine mein kya hota hai? That is the kind of attitude. Let me tell you that when I, you know, he talked about picking at the right time. I fell in inter-CA examinations, both the groups. But when I came to final CA, I had one goal, that I must get into the rank. I must be in the merit list. And you know the kind of leave I got? 4 months. Now, that is the time when I decided that yes, I will do it, and, you know, come what may. But the 3 years of articleship, I decided for myself that I will give my heart and soul into my articleship. To such an extent that, you know, once I remember my birthday, after, you know, few days, we didn't have mobile, nobody would remind you, no WhatsApp, nothing. See,
people are more intelligent than us, but that intelligence you should use it, not abuse it. Because every succeeding generation is more intelligent than the preceding one. You would be, you know, watching the toddlers now. You know, they are more computer savvy, technology savvy. But at the same time, there are a lot of distractions. So you must, you know, be very careful about it. So friends, have confidence in yourself. These 2 months also, if you devote religiously 2.5 months, you will pick at the right time for the exams. I wish all the best to you. Please wait for one more minute. Raj Khanna, please propose a hearty vote of thanks. He will.
Good evening to one and all present here.
Good evening.
In the words of APJ Abdul Kalam, success is achieved when signatures turn into autographs. After this inspiring and motivational talk by CA Nilesh Vikamsi sir, I am pretty confident that all our signatures will turn into autographs in the near future. On behalf of the BCS and the BCS Students Forum, it is a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks to CA Nilesh Vikamsi sir, who from his hectic schedule has shared his valuable time and experience for all of us present here. I would like to express my gratitude to CA Nilesh Vikamsi sir for guiding us in how to prepare for CA exams and what are the do's and don'ts for the same. Nilesh Vikamsi sir, in this short span of time, has taught us important lessons of our life. He has taught us how to excel in our CA exams and has shared his success story. Last but not the least, I would like to say one important thing that we should learn from this study meet is that, a lecture meeting is that knowledge should be shared and not saved. I think this proverb would be very appropriate that clearing CA exam is not easy, but it is worth it. Thank you, all the best. One more announcement, the next session will be a full day workshop on practical issues on TDS on 23rd March 2013 at Navin Bhai Thakkar Hall. Also, there is a lecture meeting on taxation of expatriates on 9th April 2014. I hope that everyone participates in it. And also, I request everyone to participate in the student forum activities, the student study circle and the annual day and various other student activities. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much.